Allah Almighty has created us in a way that He wants us to navigate through hardship from time to time in order to refine us, strengthen us, allow us to move on to the next level, in order to help us connect with Him in a better way, in order for us to realize the favors He has bestowed upon us, in order for us to lead a better life eventually. Had it not been for hardship, we would not have known what ease is. People do not appreciate something until they experience the opposite. You wouldn't know what cold is until you know what hot is. You wouldn't know what growth is or profit until you know what loss is. In the same way, sometimes we are leading a life of ease and we don't realize it. So Allah Almighty says, we want you to understand that we have given you ease. We've given you good health. We've given you so much of goodness. So we will take it away for a while in order for you to appreciate that we have actually blessed you. And then when it's taken away, do not despair. Do not become despondent. Don't be a person who gives up on your own Maker who's blessed you all along. But rather, understand and remember, it's just a period of time. It's just a phase. It's just a passing cloud. It's just a moment that we will have to endure. For indeed, as you bear patience, days will come that will allow you to witness ease one after the other by the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. There is no one from amongst us, no one seated here, no one who is going to watch this, who has only ever had everything easy throughout their lives in a way that they wish and they want. When mankind calls out to Allah, he asks Allah. Why would he ask Allah? When Allah Almighty loves you, He grants you the acceptance to engage in worship, because He doesn't need that worship. We know we are believers. So we know that Allah Almighty does not need you to worship Him. It's you who needs to worship Him. The benefit of your worship is yours and not the Almighty's. Like Allah Almighty says, if everyone is going to disobey Allah, it does not displace the value of Allah or the ownership of Allah in the smallest way, not at all. But rather it's for us. When I obey Allah, I will achieve the benefit of that obedience. When I am trying to get connected to my Maker, I will achieve the benefit of it. In the last few days, I have spoken about how when you believe in the Almighty and you have hope in His mercy, the quality of your life is far better than the one who doesn't believe in the Almighty, becomes depressed and sad when things happen.